I go by the name Crippindale, and I'm here to tell you a bit about myself. You see, I come from a home where privacy is my best enemy, and under a roof that where everyone sleeps soundly but never independently. Try moving 5 steps, then you're outside inhaling the subliminal air of immorality. There's no corridor, no room for the master, no security bars. I don't want to even mention a garage because we know nothing about cars, no paintings and no living room. But hey, we are happy because we are living in a room. There is sign 180 privacy, and if my house were a ship, its captain will never be a victim of piracy. Because the only time you find privacy is when you're on the ATK at Unko. And even with that, we don't realize it because we are so busy trying to increase the tertiary colored staff that lies beneath it. And though, we dare not miss time the timing as the queue outside is gradually aligning. You see, life in my neighborhood isn't easy, especially when nobody is willing to cater. Almost everyone from my hood have no jobs, so these girls have no option than to give blue jobs. The guys, they pick arms and rob from the arms of those who have abundance in their arms and yet refuse to give arms. Those who don't have the courage to do so depends on we the others, and that becomes a huge blow, because most of them are killed and others are arrested. These girls are subjected to men who use them as they wish, and they dare not reject them because the only way they can live to see tomorrow is to rely on the poultry and money to provide it, you see. Just like you are all trying to survive. And those of us who have ambition for higher education have no option than to enroll in scamming senior high, where we pick our bags and head to the cafe from night till morning, trying to dupe a dude somewhere in London or Croydon. Again, don't blame me, because like you, I'm also trying to survive. My whole community is like a battlefield. There is no law, there is no order. The sound of gunshots is our alarms. Weekly funerals give us the taste to several beverages. To us, we are living in our own dimension. My whole community is like a do or die kind of survival for the fittest. But the things we do in order not to die don't really fit us. Drugs, crimes, prostitution, and all those nasty pictures. They are the things we do, they are the things that depict us. But I see all of these things could be averted, but like the last electron of a sodium atom on the M shell, we all have been neglected. Because the only time this government officials realize they exist on a country's map is during an election. When they come and declare their false intentions, crossing their heartless hearts and repeating the same promise they failed to fulfill at Elmina Junction about the expansions of mansions and how they'll help us if we help their selfless dream function. But help me answer this question. Would you expand a building if it's already a mansion? Why spend huge sums of money refurbish schools when there are schools which still sit under trees with little dudes who still use tools and lack basic academic tools? Well, I guess they are also trying to survive. Because the only time this government officials realize they exist on the country's map is when there's a need to account for the yearly statistics. When they come and count the number of unemployed. When they come and count the number of school dropouts. When they come and count the number of those who've died from hunger. When they come and collect all of these samples. When they come. You see, I can go on, but I don't want to choke from examples. All that I'm trying to say is that my hood makes their work easier, especially after recovering 98% of the country's population who've died from cholera. They live with smiles on their faces, but why should it happen so? This ain't Paul's era. And even in their time, I don't think such thing existed as cholera. How I wish errors were humans with phones. I just would have picked mine and called error. You see, anytime I get to this point of this piece, I don't feel like continuing because it's nowhere to tell. You see, it's human nature. The more you tell a person about your plight, it begins to sound like a joke in the person's ear. So I don't want this one to sound like that as well. So this message are the voices of the inhabitants of our slums, the less endowed, and all those communities that have been left in isolation. We say, if there's anyone out there, and what you do to survive is strictly to help mankind survive. Don't be selfish. Help us survive.